Do you think it's possible that big cities are dealing with these smash and grab robberies right now, an increase in criminal activity, because some prosecutors are too soft on crime?
I would say we have seen, I'm not going to attribute the reasoning from here. What I will tell you is we have seen an increase in crime over the course of the pandemic. There are a range of reasons for that. And what our focus is on is what we can do to address it. The president has proposed additional funding in the budget to make sure local police departments and cops have the funding they need. We have also worked directly with police departments in areas where they are seeing the highest impact of the crime, the retail theft, which we have great concern about. That's what our focus is on currently, is action and doing what we can to make sure the funding is out there to the communities that need it the most.
But I guess, what good does it do if you're going to give police departments extra money if they arrest bad guys and they bring them to jail and then they're not prosecuted? They're just right back out on the streets.
I think, Peter, what our focus is on is making sure that the local leaders, the police officers and departments who know what they need for these communities, have the assistance and the funding they need. And that's what we're working around the clock on.
So the final one would be, just in the last week, we saw a New York Post item about a pickpocket with more than 30 arrests back out on the street. We've seen an arsonist burn down a $500,000 Christmas tree in New York City back out on the streets. Does the president think that's good governing?
Again, I think I've spoken to the president's concerns about retail theft. If you have specific and the actions we've taken for specific cases, I would point you to the local police departments or the Department of Justice.
Big cities are dealing with smash and grab robberies. A record number of police officers have been shot and killed this year. What is President Biden going to do about all this lawlessness?
Well, Peter, I would say that, one, the president proposed additional funding in his budget. Over the funding that had been proposed by the prior president to increase and support local police departments, make sure we keep cops on the beat, and we ensure that local communities are working in partnership to crack down on crime and any dangers they see in their community. So that's one of the steps. We've also worked with a range of communities across the country on strike forces, as you know, something we've talked about in the past. We're continuing to implement that from the Department of Justice. But the president absolutely believes that community police forces can have an important instrumental effect in helping keep communities safe.
And does the president still think that crime is up because of the pandemic?
I think many people have conveyed that, and also one of the reasons that crime, one of the root reasons crime, root causes of crime in communities is guns and gun violence, and we've seen that statistically around the country.
But to your point, so when a huge group of criminals organizes themselves and they want to go loot a store, a CVS, a Nordstrom, a Home Depot, until the shelves are clean, you think that's because of the pandemic?
I think a root cause in a lot of communities is the pandemic, yes.